In 2012, a meteor exploded over central Sri Lanka. Fragments were quickly collected and sent to labs for analysis. But when researchers examined one of the pieces under a microscope, they didn't find just minerals or metals. They found structures that looked biological, including what appears to be fossilized diatoms, microscopic algae encased inside the space rock. So the question wasn't just what the meteor was made of, it was about where it came from. The meteor, classified as a carbonaceous chondrite, was recovered near the town of Palonarua. Inside were perfectly preserved silica-based diatoms, remarkably similar to freshwater species found on Earth. Some scientists claim the fossils show signs of being fossilized before entering Earth's atmosphere, meaning they weren't from here at all. Now, this led to a bold claim that the meteorite may be the first hard evidence of panspermia, the theory that life can travel between planets on space rocks. Mainstream scientists pushed back hard. They argued the diatoms could have been Earth-based contamination, perhaps picked up after the meteor landed. Others pointed out that the fossilized shapes, while compelling, weren't impossible to mimic in nature. Plus, the idea that life exists or traveled through space is still controversial. But here's the twist. The team behind the claim published in the peer-reviewed journal and stood by their results. They insisted the structures were embedded too deep to be from surface contamination. So if they didn't come from Earth, where did they come from? If the diatoms inside the meteorite are real and really extraterrestrial, they'd be the first fossils ever found from outside our planet. But without more samples or repeatable findings, the mystery remains stuck between science and speculation. Was it proof of life beyond Earth, or just the Earth clinging to a rock from space?